here at the California Democratic Convention, and it's always exciting, interesting, dynamic. All the movers and shakers are here. Elected officials, people running for office, and delegates. Today I'm asking, how can we get more women to run for office? Let's see what people have to say.
Well, we need to get more women to run for office. We only have about 25% of the women who are in our state legislature. About 14% of women are in Congress. On the City Council in Los Angeles, I'm only one of two women out of 15. So I think we need to get more women to run for office by mentoring them, training them. But more importantly, we've got to get financial help for women. It's very difficult for women to raise money. If we can tell women that we're going to help raise money, that Emily's List, that California's List, that NOW and NWPC will raise money, I think that's the biggest hurdle for most women.
Well, we could shoot all the men, but I think we'd be in trouble if we did that. But I think really it's really about outreach and telling women that they can actually run for office and win. Sometimes we think we're really not capable of doing that thing, so I think education and getting people out to educate people that they can run and how to win, just like Emily's List did so many years ago for Congress.
I think it's the encouragement that women are already running that's pushing women into the forefront and seeing the ability that they can bring to the table.
We have to show that anything is possible for women, and probably the best role models for that right now are the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi, and the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, both of whom I count as friends, and who are showing women that if you go for it, you can rise to the highest level. And we have a lot of talented young women who are at this convention who are seeing Nancy Pelosi walk around and figuring out that maybe, just maybe, if they work hard, they can be a Speaker of the House.
I think because women, especially in my generation, have always been helped by men, we're not so apt to help other women, and we need to be cognizant of that. And that's why it's very important that we make history this year and really elect the first woman lieutenant governor, and that's what I'm trying to do, so that we start showing other younger women that it can be done.
Financially, with actions, not just words, and I think that we need to start to foster leadership in our young women. Just kind of encourage them to take on leadership roles, to put themselves out there, to take on and tackle some of the difficult policy issues I think that women face, and bring a different voice to politics, to policy.
Just have to believe. We have to believe. We're half the population. It's a matter of women standing up for our daughters, our sisters, our theas, our aunts, our grandmothers, and believing that women have a strong voice. We have a tremendous power when we harness it. And when women vote, women win. I think a lot of it is making sure that we mentor each other, we open the doors. We will never smash the glass ceiling if we don't open the door in the first place to bring women into the mix.
It's absolutely critical that women participate in our public democracy and our civic governance. They understand the critical nature of the economy in these especially difficult times. They bring a unique skill set, and so I think it's important that everybody encourage their friends of all stripes and persuasions, of all orientations, of all both genders, to participate in the political process.
It's interesting to hear what people have to say about women running for office. We definitely need more women for office, running in statewide positions, and who knows, maybe even governor. California is a trend-setting state, so I'd like to see that in the future. This is Sylvia Robledo for Political Sazón. See you next time.